Hello and welcome to the 1 Minute Rewatch. I am TC DeWitt and today I shall be your garbage man. September is in full swing, which means one thing in the movie world, dump month.
Dump month!
Yes, that special biannual time of the year when critical and commercial expectations are at their lowest. The tent poles of the summer are done. The kids are back in school. There are no major holidays to speak of and studios release movies that wouldn't stand a chance during the prime season with a resounding September's the perfect time of year for movies with less prominent stars, genre movies, crappy horror. I mean, look at this list of films from September. The highest grossing September release movie of all time is Crocodile Dundee from 1986. That's how crappy this month is. But there is a 2016 September release that does have some cred behind it, The Blair Witch. And because Lionsgate thought it was a good idea to return to the world so masterfully expanded upon in Blair Witch 2, Book of Shadows. Yikes. I figured I would go back to the Black Hills of Burkittsville, Maryland to the film that launched a genre. In 1999, the internet did not exist as it does today. When the Blair Witch preview said that this was a found footage movie about three kids who vanished searching for a witch, people thought it was a documentary, and the marketing behind it was like nothing anyone had ever seen. It was viral marketing before that was a thing, and even after people saw the movie, it wasn't clear if it was real or not. But it's 17 years later, the gimmick doesn't work anymore. Found footage is an overused, ineffective genre. We know the Blair Witch is fake, so that means that this movie is just a movie and must be critiqued as such. The characters are annoying, screaming and arguing, albeit realistically, but they aren't actors, and it comes off as amateur at best. The video camera look is difficult to watch for extended period of times. It's not surprising many people barf from motion sickness in the theatrical run, and why Paranormal Activity figured the best method was to lock the camera down. But if you follow the tales up to the ending, you will feel that chill. It's not well acted, but it's well executed. And with so many awful found footage movies out there, it's nice to watch one that doesn't know what it was creating. It didn't fool itself into thinking it was some epic horror movie. It's just spooky enough that 17 years later, it still works and can stick with you when it's over. And that's why I'm giving the Blair Witch Project 3.5 Scooby-Doos out of 5. Ruh-roh. So maybe the Blair Witch is about to dethrone Crocodile Dundee after 30 years on top of Dump Month.
Dump Month!
Time will tell. What do you guys think? Agree? Disagree? The Blair Witch Project, yay or nay? Let me know in the comments below. Or if you want to see me review something in the future, put it down there as well. And if you haven't done it already, hit subscribe, hit like, check out all the cool content we have here at the BitLife Show, including Working Title and my ghost dad, Chad Halverson, over at the 1 Minute Gamer. And if you want to hear me talk at length about movies, check out my podcast, The ReWatchmen, which is available on iTunes. Well, that's all for the 1 Minute Rewatch this time. I am TC DeWitt, and you would have gotten away with it if it weren't for those meddling kids. So maybe the Blair Witch is about to dethrone Crocodile Dundee. So maybe the Blair Witch is about to dethrone Crocodile Dundee. So maybe Crocodile Dundee is about to be dethroned of third. So maybe the Blair Witch is about to dethrone Crocodile Dundee. God.